policy of above all of the above approach to energy is the antithesis of a leader's action who is interested or cares to address this problem, especially with the advent of so much renewable energy. That includes hydrofracking, ethanol, nuclear, all of these things are antiquated.
Okay.
It's time to move forward.
You're probably one of the biggest celebrities here so far, at least, to be in the march. I mean, do you think by having a big name of yourself that puts a face on it and kind of gets more people energized?
There's amazing people here. There's Sandra Steingraber here, who's one of the great leaders in the fracking movement.
Oh. And Sierra Club has a program going fossil-free by 2030. What do you think about that goal as being something realistic and something that maybe we have to work towards?
Well, the goal of keeping all fossils in the ground by 2030 is exactly what the science says that we need to do. So that that's a science-based goal that shows us that if we could achieve that, we could avoid the worst of the planetary tipping points. And so that's the moral imperative here, and that's why we not only have to close the door on coal and oil, but also on natural gas, and not build out another fossil fuel infrastructure with investments that require 40 or 50 years to go by before we can see reward on investment. So we need to stop building out the infrastructure for all fossil fuels now in order to keep those things in the ground by 2030.
Testing the podium microphone.
Van Fracking.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Wisconsin. It's really important because they're starting to frack, and it's affecting Lake Michigan.